coming up next. It's a UFC featherweight division fight. One of the more accomplished strikers in this division. Sprawl and brawl, whatever you want to say, he's going to try to keep this fight standing tonight.
It does not matter how he accomplishes it. All he wants to do is be on his feet and at range, hitting you with the beautiful jab, staying away from the grappling exchanges. You don't accomplish all the things that this man has accomplished over the course of his career without understanding distance. He has great distance management, which then in turn allows him to land all these beautiful, diverse kicks, spinning back kick, jumping high kick, so many things he possesses that he will try to use tonight in this fight.
Yeah, if this turns into a kickboxing match tonight, most people believe, yeah, his opponent is in a world of trouble. Well, this is exciting here, DC. The founder of Jeet Kune Do, one of the founding fathers, really, of mixed martial arts, Bruce Lee, is back in a big spot here tonight.
Bruce Lee is what every kid looked to when they thought about doing karate. Bruce Lee is the person that anyone looked at when they said, I want to be a fighter. It was the speed. It was the charisma. It was the approach of Bruce Lee that made him so special. And tonight, he's going to look to show a new generation of fighters exactly how it's supposed to be done.
And if you hear the phrase, drillers make killers, right? I mean, that was Bruce Lee in a nutshell. He felt like practice would make perfect. Nobody trained as hard as the great Bruce Lee. All right, now let's get to the tail of the tape for this featherweight tilt. So these fighters relatively close in age, just a year apart, and they both possess a similar height and reach. Here once more, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon is Herb Dean. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Madison Square Garden Arena in New York City, it's time! 5 rounds in the UFC featherweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a kickboxer, making his professional debut here tonight. He stands 5'8" tall, weighing in at 145 pounds. Fighting out of London, England, Mystery. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a mixed martial artist making his professional debut here tonight. He stands 5'7" tall, weighing in at 145 pounds. Fighting out of Los Angeles, California, USA, Bruce the Dragon Lee.
You've been given your instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We will have a clean fight. Touch gloves. Let's make it official.
And with that touch of the gloves, we are underway.
Ready. You ready to fight?
Well, the tension is palpable as this fight gets underway, and it'll be interesting to see how this matchup plays out. Definite striker on one side against another guy who can do it.
And in those situations, normally the guy that's more well-rounded will be the one that will find success. I want to see how this plays out.
Whoa! Oh! Oh, he goes with the punch and he lands. All right, so you got to be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long. Oh, he gets back up, but barely. Look how wobbly he is. Oh, that's a good strike there by Lee. Lands a nice straight punch there. Now we'll see if he can follow it up.
What do you follow up a great punch like this with? I'm excited to see what happens.
And he counters with a left hand. Oh, hard work pays off. Lands Superman punch flush.
Cable inches right there. Wow. It was a good night if that landed.
And he connects with the punch there. Lee going for the body, targeting that area with the kick, but unable to land. Just over 3 minutes to go. And he connects there with a punch, so pretty good striking display by him thus far.
He throws everything so straight and so accurate. It's a beautiful, fast, quick jab with meaning.
They continue to exchange. A lot of people think he might have the best jab in this division, certainly using it effectively here.
I mean, one of the best jabs in the world across all combat sports. The way that it just comes out, it's beautiful. The backside hand is always at the chin. The elbows tucked to the ribs. The jab goes out. The jab comes right back to the face. It's picture-perfect technique, almost like a Taibo class or something like that. Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one up?
Swing and a miss by Lee.
Liver kick, if you take those kicks, it's gonna shut your body off.
And he landed the right hand there. Oh, pinpoint knee to the body. If you're trying to knock me out, you put one knee to the body.
Every time the opponent tries to get close, he just drives that knee to the body. Great timing.
Just misses with the jab there.
Look at him drive his shin into his opponent's body with that body kick. Big powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range.
Oh, misses with the jab.
It's very tricky when he throws that body kick.
Changes his stance. Nice defense there, huge block. Oh, nice kick right there. Tell the masses how good that feels to get kicked like that.
John, it doesn't. It doesn't feel good to get kicked like that.
And both guys really throwing with authority.
What a tricky head kick. Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks.
Throws a big right hand, but doesn't find its home.
Nice.
Oh, he lands another strike to the body. Really starting to connect on a lot of shots to the midsection. And these will take their toll as this fight goes into the latter rounds. That horn sounds means we have reached the end of round one. All right, so there's the end of the round, and the tide has officially turned. A huge head strike to stun his opponent. We'll see which corner can adjust here moving forward.
I mean, they've got to be celebrating. They've got to be happy. Everything's working. But the other side has to be concerned. They have to figure something out, make some sort of adjustment to try to change the tide of this fight.
All right, round two. Oh, good head movement there. Nice left. All right, so a nice job there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave where they're supposed to be. And if you do that, most times you will block the shot that's incoming.
Well, he's been pretty accurate tonight. He's landed some significant strikes, but his corner's looking for him to mix it up a little bit more and just throw more volume.
Because they don't see too much of a threat. This guy has to have confidence in knowing that when he extends his combinations, he's still safe, but he's also gonna be able to land. He's gotta be finding that confidence in his mind that all the reps in the training room are going to pay off.
Oh, the kickboxing chops on full display with that offering. Nicely done.
Beautiful kick landed by this man.
So a big knockdown for him in the previous round. Confidence is high and building here in this next round.
Confidence is key, and he has a ton of it right now. Nice punch lands over the top. Beautiful body kick lands right under the elbow.
Just over 3 minutes now to go. Oh, spinning back fist. He didn't telegraph that one at all. Well, he was a little bit lackluster in round one. You can't say the same here in this second round. He has really picked up the pace, an uptick in the aggression and the output, and starting to find his range here in the pocket.
Look at the force behind that leg kick. Ooh, big shot lands.
Opponent in a world of trouble.
Such a sneaky head kick. He did not recognize it. It was coming high, and now he's got him hurt bad.
Almost in range with the straight left, but that's a miss. Just unable to quite find that range. How about that shin?
Big liver kick lands under the elbow. Caught that kick there. Straight punch lands. You can really limit the mobility of your opponent with those leg kicks.
Again, he's looking for that left. It's not there. Flush with that right hand. Wild swing there. Oh, and he continues to pour it on. We mentioned earlier the aggression with his striking. Got to be careful to not gas out here, but at least you have to admire the approach. That shot blocked by Lee. Just out of range with that left hook.
Great punch landed with so much power.
Tags him with a flush left. Hardy closes the distance, gets the single collar tie. Rips the body there for good measure. All right, round three coming up next.
Won that last round. He was all over you. He did better than that. Come on now. Let's shake it out. Let's get back in there. Let's get back to the game plan. Hands high. Work behind.
All right, now we take a look back at some of the highlights. He has had his kicking game going early and often tonight.
I mean, on point, right? He knew that this was gonna be a way for him to take control of this fight. He's used those kicks to really put him out ahead, and I'm not sure if his opponent has the ability to adjust and stop him from landing these over and over.
All right, we'll see how it goes here in this next round. A high number of kicks landed there in the previous round, and at some point, these are gonna really start to take their toll.
They do start to take an effect whenever you're taking kick after kick after kick, and watching him fight with that knowledge and that patience shows his fight IQ. Look at the angle of that nice body. Caught that. Now, there's danger in that, too, because when you start reaching out to catch that kick, here comes the high kick, and
well, he continues to land a high number of strikes here, just like he did in the previous round. This is a world-class display of striking here tonight. Oh, setting up the left hook, but out of range. Pretty good right hand. Lee's kick to the body is blocked.
Look at how he turns his hip into that leg kick. Oh, that's a nice strike. Nice, sneaky head kick.
Back and forth we go!
Beautiful body kick.
Able to check that kick as well.
You don't know when that leg kick's coming.
He lands another strike to the body here, really starting to connect on a lot of strikes to the midsection here in the latter stages of this fight. Oh, and he connects with a punch there, DC. You like this guy.
I like this guy a ton. And to watch his punch, like, just puts a smile on my face.
Out of range with that one.
Liver kick.
How good is that right hand? Lee going for the leg kick. Nothing doing there. Well, this is exactly the sense of urgency you're looking for. Try to take the judges out of it. He is lighting them up now. Just out of range with that right hook. Lee gets hit with a kick here. Let's see how he responds.
Big punch lands through the middle.
Big knee. Big knee.
Good right here.
Huge block there. Try to establish that jab. And he caught the kick. And he engages in the single collar tie.
Over and over. You come up, you go down. Oh, nice guillotine there.
Oh, look at this. Jumps over into side mount to try to counter the guillotine. Maybe going with that Von Flute choke. I guess we should probably call it the OSP at this point. In the fight. All right, full guard here, DC. What does he need to do to improve position?
Well, he's got to start to build his posture, get some damage off, move to half guard, which in turn leads to more opportunities for advancement. But if you're on the bottom, you've got to anticipate those movements. The moment he tries to move to the next position, you build a shield, get back to your feet, or dig an underhook to try to get a reversal or a sweep.
Oh, he's got the ground and pound going now. Bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC. Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
15 seconds to go. Outstanding ground and pound here. Somewhat of a lost art in MMA, at least in terms of making sure that every strike counts. Not an issue for him.
He's making every single one of them count. He is not pity-patting. He's not touching. Every punch that lands, he wants you to feel it.
That's three rounds in the can. We're headed to the championship rounds. Well, what a round it was, especially from a striking standpoint. DC, take us through.
High-level striking. I mean, this is what people come through the doors to see. Two men stand on a quarter, chest to chest, forehead to forehead, and let it all fly. I'm surprised nobody went out, but it does excite me for the next round.
All those sprints, all the conditioning we did in the gym.
All right, so here we go with our next round. DC, you are known for having one of the higher fight IQs in the game, and I would put him on that list after what we saw in terms of the body work there in the previous round.
He did a fantastic job.
And maybe time to get the bonus checks ready.
I mean, this fight is about done. He's got him hurt very bad with his head kick. Now he has to find one more strike to end the night.
Well, just as he did in the previous round, he continues to connect on a high volume of strikes. And a good sign, too, doesn't seem to be slowing down whatsoever.
Look at the whip action that comes from him throwing that kick.
Throwing that jab, no good. Blocks that kick to the body.
Nice head kick.
You see, he's trying to get the timing down to set up that counter, but just misses there.
What a body kick.
Oh, beautiful head movement. Slips there. Just misses with the right hook. Lee gets caught with that punch.
Big leg kick land.
He gets crushed with that hook.
Turn it around.
Just over 3 minutes to go now.
Nice lucid punch. Look at him working at trying to shut the liver down. He's throwing every part of himself into these big leg kicks.
Timely defense there. Huge block for him. Oh, that right hand is on point. And now they are throwing both sides with conviction. Well, it's one thing to have length. It's another thing to use it. And he does it as well as anyone. Nice kick there by Lee.
Cut them down to size with these beautiful leg kicks.
I want that
there, DC.
He landed that massive shot. Now he needs to try to find the next shot, the follow-up shot, that will finish the fight.
Under 2 minutes to go. Much improved defensively as he blocks the shot.
Look at how he turns his hip over when he throws that kick.
Straight right hand now just misses. Lee gets caught with that punch. All right, so there he goes, continuing to land that jab. When they put this highlight together, it's just gonna be one head snapping back.
It's gonna be boxers going back and watching this guy and going, wow, this is what a jab is supposed to look like. He loaded up on that right hand, too.
Oh, and a nice jab by him there, and that's gonna give his opponent some problems if that keeps landing.
He's having a tough time getting his offense going because that jab is just stopping him every time.
tie here.
Game of inches right there, boy. Wow. It was a good night if that landed. Beautiful strike. What a great way of mixing up his attack. He didn't stay the course. He mixed it up. He went high with him. Low. And now he's got him hurt very badly.
Oh, wicked nice leg kick there, DC.
Can't take too many of those.
Buzzer sounds for the end of round four. 20 minutes in the books. Why, so there is the horn at times in that previous round. I didn't think we'd get here after that head kick nearly had him out of there.
It was a good round leading up to that. But when you take a head kick like that, when your opponent gets your entire body into that kick, usually the night's over. Very tough to still be standing, but he can't take many more like that.
All right, next round getting underway here, and both fighters still look pretty fresh to me. Clearly, DC, they put in the right work when it came to the cardio during training.
They both have reputation for vast cardio. You see in the training that they do at their gyms that cardio is key, and you watch it in the way that these two fighters perform.
Beat into the punch, be first.
You take more of these leg kicks, you will not be able to be very active on your feet.
Just misses with the straight right.
Punches and bunches, punches and bunches.
Lee gets caught with that punch. Got to shore up the defense here.
Big head kick lands.
Let's get some offense. Let's get going.
There's the kick. It's blocked. Back and forth we go here.
That was lightning fast, that right hand. Nice kick. Real quick leg kick.
Blocks that strike.
Nice body kick right under the elbows. Liver kicks, if you take those kicks, it's gonna shut your body off.
Missed with that attempt.
Caught the kick.
Lee gets absolutely punished by that head kick.
Keep your hands up. Use your footwork now.
That one snuck in. Nice strike.
Just over 3 minutes now to go in the fight. Lee gets touched by that leg kick attempt. All right, well, time is the enemy now, DC, and he's really running out of it if he's going to get his hand raised tonight.
He's got to go forward. He's got to just throw everything at his opponent to try and find that punch or that kick that's going to end the fight. There is no time for strategy anymore. I mean, look at the commitment to kicking in this fight. Nice leg kick.
Going back to his patented kicks here, but unable to find the target there.
There's no give on that leg kick.
Under 2 minutes now to decide this one.
He ate that kick. He took that whole kick, yep.
Oh!
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish this fight. Nice punch lands. Big leg kick lands. real sneaky body kick.
Man, look at him load up on that right. Under 1 minute to go, fifth and final round.
Big punch lands. Ooh. Look at him whip his hip into that kick. Big liver kick lands under the elbow.
Seconds left.
Good punch lands.
Well, not much setup behind it. The right hook misses. What a fight!
Body kick right there, landed perfect.
All right, so we now look back at some of the action from that previous round, DC. A lot of good highlights on both sides.
I mean, a lot of good highlights from both competitors. They both should be very proud of what they accomplished. But I'm telling you, man, I'm not sure they can keep this up. If they land at this clip for another 5 minutes, somebody's going to sleep.
The official decision is in. It resides with Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 5 rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. All 3 judges score this contest 50-45. Declare the winner by unanimous decision, Bruce the Dragon Lee!
All right, congratulations to him. He is your winner by unanimous decision and certainly a dominant performance here tonight.
Yeah, he did a great job of just dictating and controlling all the engagements of this fight. His opponent never really had an opportunity to lead the dance. He did that from start to finish, and he wins a unanimous.